suicide light this morning, the first person who saw me approached me. And apparently, he just sat alone. Ang una kong tinanong niya o sinabi niya sa akin, parang kailangan niyo. Kailangan niyo. This remark is not new to me because every time I get into Jews, people make that remark. Mukhang healthy ni Jesus. Dahil na kapag bakang buhay pa. Because of my height, maybe, and my weight also. People mistake me to be younger than my age. But I consider that as a great compliment. Masaya po ako at nag-inig ko yung mga ganyan ng mga babae. Kasi ayaw natin kapag sinasabi ng kanyang bakit matanda ang itsura mo? Mitwa ang itsura? Katwa ang itsura? You look rather very old to me. Making enemies when people tell us that. Hindi nyo may itagabi nyo kung ano yung itsura. Mukhang maganda. Maganda kaysa sa kanyang kilala. Maybe you can start whispering, easy ka lang. Don't be too anxious. Don't worry. Be happy. You look too old. You look too tired. And the Father is present. When we are in the house of the Father, nakatanda kasi masabi yung too much anxiety, worries in our life. We forget at times to become faithful, to always remember that the Father is in charge of our affairs. But today is the feast of the Sanctum. That is why we have that beautiful image of the Sanctum in the Sanctum. The Santorino is our God who never looks, gets old, and is yet to matanda. Forever young, looks very young, hindi to matanda ang kanyang itsura. It's ironic because whenever we address God, we say, Ako Gino, Poon, Panginoon, Ako. But today we address Him as not just Ako, but I mean Ako, the younger. The young God, the God who never looks old. That is who the Santorino is. It's a constant reminder that God never looks old. Not only in appearance, but in His divinity, in His status. I was contemplating on this question. I wonder why God never grows old. Bakit hindi ko matanda yung itsura ng Santo Domingo? And I received so many answers during my contemplation. Maybe because God has no problems, He has no problema. Pag wala kang utang na binabayaran, kapag wala kang problema sa buhay, hindi ka tatanda na sa akin. Hindi ka mabilis pumuti yung buho. Mag-grinder sa mukha. That is not good. Maybe the Lord has no problems. O kaya, wala siyang boss. Kapag may boss niya, mag-inis ka ka lang dahil. Lalo na kapag yung boss mo ay medyo stricto. Maghirap ka kipagana. How you wish you could retire as early as possible. But, you cannot. You will have to suffer. Your life in His hands. Panginoon, wala siyang boss, kaya siguro hindi kumatanda. Wala siyang asawa. Sabi nila, nakakatanda yung may asawa. Well, mas nakakatanda po yung walang asawa. Tingnan niyo kami mga tayo. 30s pa lang, parang 50s. We grow old early, kaya kasi minamanuhan niyo kasi kami. Tinatawag niyo kami ako. That is why we also look old easily. But really, ano ba yung dahilan? Looking into the gospel text this Sunday, in this liturgy, taken from the Gospel of St. Luke, the Lord gives us His answer, but He never goes home. The gospel is about the finding lost. Jesus got lost and He was found in the temple. Mother Mary was very anxious and worried. For 3 days, inaccess Jesus, no doubt. For 3 days. And when they found Him, He was inside the temple, listening to the scribes and teachers of the Lord, and impressing Him with His question, His understanding, His wisdom, and His answers. But that did not control the anxiety of our Mother Mary. So she approached the Son and said, "Son, how have you done this to us? Bakit ginawa mo sa amin ito?" It's so worried, looking for you, your Father and I. And the response of the Lord Jesus is what I'm talking about. He said, "Why are you looking for me? Why are you anxious? I am in my Father's house. Nandito ko sa pamamahay ng aming Ama." And now Mary did not understand the response. She just bowed her head in silence and simply says she kept everything in her mind. Itinamon niya sa kanyang puso ang lahat ng bagay. It's a mystery when all her life was mystery. And here is another mystery that folded before. I cannot understand. But as a faithful disciple of the Son, she simply kept this in her heart and learned from the Son. Today we learn from the Son of the Lord. What does it mean? What does He mean when He says, "I am in my Father's house"? Meron po ako sa favorite movie yung matagal nito movie na ito, Home Alone. I'm sure you have watched the movie. It's about the family set to go on vacation. They were so lost about so many things, they forgot about the children. Imagine, lahat ng pag-ahe mo, kapag-atanda ka rin, kanilang anak, nakalimutan na natutulog. They realized that and they were already on the plane. And so it's too late. But the mother was so worried. We have to come back. And so the story revolved around coming back, a tedious journey, ang daming perya, hindi makauwi-uwi. And the Son found out he was left behind, but no problem. He handled the situation quite well. Mayroong mga magnanakaw-tawal. This is a comedy film. And the comedy in the film showed how the Son was so confident, was not afraid at all. Parang sinabi niya sa pelikula, "I am in my home. I am in the home of my Father and Mother. This is my house and nothing will ever happen to me." Everybody was full of light, was able to defend the house. Everybody. Nung dumating yung kanyang mga magulang, they were so distressed and spent, pero itong bata, relaxed.